Hello everybody, Chad here, and welcome back to another Cooking Simulator 5-star tutorial. In this video, I will be showing you how to get a 5-star quality on steak with barbecue sauce and vegetables, the upgraded version of steak with french fries. This recipe is almost entirely different from its downgraded version, the steak with french fries, because it adds two entirely new components, changes up the steak a little bit, and then changes up the garnish also. So, it may be a bit different. Oh, actually, it'll be a lot different from what you know from the steak with french fries. Pretty much everything that you learned while making the steak with french fries will be thrown away to the side, often to nowhere. And you'll probably not use that again once you've upgraded it to the steak with barbecue sauce and vegetables. But let's not sit here talking for too long, and let's get right into it. First off, the ingredients that we are going to need for this recipe is steak, black pepper, salt, chili flakes, sweet bell pepper, sugar, water, mustard, wine vinegar, ketchup, a white bell pepper, white, red, and green bell pepper, a button mushroom, zucchini, and a carrot. Let's get straight into this recipe, first off, by starting with the steak. And we're just going to set this to the side afterwards so we can do this part over here. But first off, to do the steak, we want to season this with 5 grams of black pepper and salt. And then that's done. Simple as that. We're going to put this over here. We'll go and put it in the pan, but we are not going to start to fry that yet. Because what we want to do is we want to make our barbecue sauce. We're going to make our barbecue sauce like this. We want to take a bowl. You can use, there is 2 types of bowls. I might be able to find the other one in here somewhere, maybe. Probably not, actually. It is not in here, but there is 2 types of bowls. There is this small one, which is what we're using, and there is a bigger one, but I do not know where it is. But regardless, you want to take a bowl, and you want to pour 20 milliliters of ketchup in there. Don't worry about any mess, it'll be fine if you get a little bit of mess on your countertop. But you want 20 milliliters of ketchup, 10 milliliters of wine vinegar, 5 milliliters of mustard, and yeah, you can go a little bit over, a little bit under, it won't hurt. Thankfully, because if it did, then this would be entirely screwed up. But then, last but not least, we want 5 milliliters of water. And then we want to add the spices to this, which is 5 grams of sugar, chili flakes, and sweet bell pepper. Just like this. And then we want to add, after we're done with that, 3 grams of black pepper and salt. Not 4, but that, thankfully, again, a little bit over, a little bit under, does not hurt the recipe. So now that we have that, we're just going to keep this here, and we're going to work on the vegetables, because this does actually take a second to do. So we have a 600 gram zucchini here. We want to cut a 150 gram piece off of this. Hopefully like that. Perfect. So the rest of that you can either throw it in the trash can if you're not using it for anything, or you can keep it to the side if you are using it for other recipes. But we then want to take this 150 gram piece, and we want to cut this into quarters. Once we've done that, we can take our fryer basket. Everything from this section of the recipe will be going into this fryer basket, so just have it nearby. Go and put the quartered zucchini in there. Now, We want to cut our carrot into 14 gram pieces, which is roughly, or not roughly, it is 5 pieces. So we want to make 4 cuts like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And while it may not be exactly perfect 14 gram pieces on every single one of them, it's good enough to get you through that. We'll take our button mushroom now, and we just simply want to cut this in half the best we can. Which you want to try and cut from where the stem is. So you can see from this angle, you can see the stem down here. You want to try and cut in half from here. Just like that. And again, not exactly perfect, but it is close enough. Now that we've got this, we want to do the same thing for every single one of these bell peppers. We want to take them and cut an 80 gram piece off, which is roughly around here. Yeah. That's good enough. It's very difficult to get precisely 80, but you want to cut around where I cut on the bell pepper, and you'll get a close to 80 gram piece. And then each 80 gram piece of these bell peppers, we want to cut into quarters. And we're going to do that just like that. Take this. Do the same thing. Rinse and repeat. Sometimes you will mess up like that, and you have to go to the other side of it or get an entirely new bell pepper. Like that, I actually do have to get a new bell pepper because I did not get a good piece off that. Oh boy. How much is left here? Aren't the only ones we want to cut like that. And whatever is. Okay, none of them are. I'm. Know I always say a little bit over, a little bit under never hurts, but you do not want to be that under. There we go. There's our 80 piece. Again, you're just rinsing and repeating the same steps that you do to the first bell pepper that you cut up. Cut that into quarters, and move on to the third one. And this is why I did not start the steak, because actually, we can do that right now, really quickly, since it has to fry on both sides. So we are going to do that. We still fry this for 45 seconds on each side. So we're going to start that like that. A little bit over. I probably could have cut that down to be what it needed to be, but I'm trying to get this as perfect as possible. And just like that, we're good. Now we're gonna come over here and we are going to flip our steak. Well, we have the second to do so. And put it on for another 45 seconds. And now that we have our last piece of bell pepper, going to once again cut this into quarters like this. Something just fell through the basket, I see. And because that happened, let's make sure everything that needs to be in here is in here. And indeed it is. So we are going to take our fryer basket now, filled with all the vegetables, fill our deep fryer, and put it down in here, and we're going to come over here really quick and stop this now that our steak is done. So now that we have our deep fryer filled and our fryer basket filled with all the vegetables that we need, we also want to set this timer for 45 seconds. And deep fry all of these vegetables for 45 seconds. In the meantime, we are going to apply the barbecue sauce to the steak that we made earlier. So we have our barbecue sauce mixture right here. And I like to... It says for you to transfer to a plate to do this. But I personally like to just bring it back over onto the cutting board and do it here just to reduce the mess on the plate. Because it will cause a mess on the plate. But we want to take our barbecue sauce mixture, and we want to just drizzle all of it straight onto our steak like that. And that is now ready to go. So we are actually going to wait for that, and we are going to put the vegetables down before the steak. So now that these are done deep frying, we want to take all these out and put them all on the plate. Button mushroom, yellow bell pepper, red bell pepper, and we're done with that. Now we can take our steak and come over here, and unlike the previous recipe, the downgrade version of this, we only want one rosemary twig. And just like this, we're going to take this over to the order station, and we should have a perfect 5-star quality steak with barbecue sauce and vegetables. You will get a little bit of a missing star sometimes. Like, for example, I got that because of the cutting technique. You can perfect this better than I can, more than likely. I did not... The carrot is something that I'm not really accustomed to cutting, so obviously it took off a little bit due to that, but it still was a 5-star. Not all the way up, but as long as your overall score is a full 5 stars, that is all that matters. That is what you want in the end. As long as you can get to that, that's what you want. And just like that, that is how you get a 5-star quality on steak with barbecue sauce and vegetables. I hope that you all found this video helpful. And if you did, be sure to drop a like on it. And if you know of any friends of yours that would benefit from watching these tutorials as well, be sure to share it around with them. Anyways, everybody, I will see you all in the next tutorials. Goodbye.